I'm going with a friend from college, and she says going, and then my roommate's Tack Logan. If you guys ever see Tack on the stream. Yeah, this is my fourth year going. I'm pretty excited. So, I mean, I'll bring my laptop. If I can stream from there, I'll try to. I'll just point the camera towards the decks, and then easy mode. I'll talk to the other DJs, be like, hey, do you guys want to be on a live stream? And if they're all okay with it, I'll just stream the entire night, because they're all good DJs, so, yeah. I live near DC. So I'm not gonna do like a stripper mix. When I submitted my mix, it was specifically for like a pre-party. I was like, because we're going to a festival, it's a festival pre-party. I submitted a mix of house and trap, just like all my favorite stuff. And yeah, they're like, yo, we like your mix, we want you to spin. I'm like, okay, it's cool. So then they're like, yeah, you're playing at the strip club. And like, it's kind of, I don't know, it's kind of bullshit to like confine me to a style and be like, nah, I don't want to do that. I mean, I'm not trying to be a diva, but like the thing is, if you submit a mix in a specific style and they want you to play something completely different, I was kind of like, yeah, this is fucking dumb. But anyways, it comes down, I can play whatever I want. So if I want to play like straight up like techno or like some really hard ass bass house shit, it's gonna be fucking crazy. I think I'm gonna just drop some really hard trap and I want to see what they do. Cause there are gonna be strippers dancing and stuff. But yeah, we'll see. Actually, the mix that I submitted for the contest is, you can go on my SoundCloud page and check it out and give it a listen. It's under the Holy Ship mixtapes. So when you typically DJ a strip club, like, I don't know if you've ever been to one, but the girls are up there for a specific amount of time, because like a girl will be up for like 3 minutes or 3.5 minutes, and then they switch, they rotate. And like in that time, you know, she's trying to make her tips and whatnot. So when you DJ a strip club, you have to play out the entire song, like you play out entire songs. And usually like it's songs that like the girls request and they want to hear. So you have like a list, and she's like, you're not even DJing, you're literally just, you're a fucking jukebox. So that was my first reaction when I heard I was going to be DJing at the strip club. I was like, what the fuck? No, that's not what I do. You should probably find someone else. But they're like, no, you just DJ normally like the way that you do. And then they'll figure out the rotation of the girls and whatnot. Yeah, so if you want to just... See, the thing, it gets hard because you have an 8-hour shift and you're sitting there just playing out entire 3-minute songs, and like the girls come back on, sometimes they want the same song. So you're just like pushing play over and over and over and for 8 hours, probably for around like minimum wage. If that wouldn't drive you fucking insane. Versus at a club, you're usually booked for you to perform. So you just play whatever you want for 1 hour, 2 hours, and it's fucking awesome. Like, the hardest part about that is, like, maybe people aren't, like, they don't fuck with what you're playing. But that's if you're booked specifically, like, for the club, it should be because, like, the way that you spin and stuff, it fits, like, the crowd that comes in. So, I mean, you should be able to adapt, but it's not so much on you. But yeah, when you're DJing at a strip club, it's literally like... like zero effort. Oh, damn, Richard, you played before? Nice. Yeah, maybe I will do Brain Power. Maybe I'll play like just some hard style and maybe Brain Power.
First you loved, then you promised. Last losing control.
Boots gets it.
Intense.
Oh, we should play some Nightcore shit. Good thinking.
Too much time. Gonna leave you far behind.
Yeah, Loki knows. It's important to, like, definitely if you're playing at a club. Well, the only clubs I ever got booked at were clubs, like, I was a regular there. I would go, like, every week, and then, like, I was friends with people that spun there, and I got to meet people, like, promoters and stuff. Like, hey, you want to play here in like, you know, 2 weeks or whatever, some shit like that.
Die. Almost. Kill me.
First time on it. It depends where these clubs are. Yeah, man, I would love to DJ in Korea. That seems so fucking fun. Yeah, I think one of my favorite gigs ever, I opened for Panic City, and he's got that very LA bass housey vibe. And so a lot of people that came out that night, they're like into that style of music, and especially like a lot of people that know him, like they listen to his stuff. So I opened up with like just a lot of deep house, and then I eased like the last 20-30 minutes, I just played a bunch of bass house, but like stuff that was leading up to what he would play. And yeah, I remember, holy shit, that was a gig. Taiwan, of course. Yeah. Well, I mean, okay. Well, low-key, it sounds like that's the spot. Whenever TwitchCon's in Korea, when there's TwitchCon... I can't fucking talk. When TwitchCon's in Korea, that'll be the spot. We'll get that spot and rent it out, and it'll be fun. She should have given you a bowl of homemade shin-ramyun. Shin-ramyun. Let's do it again. One time. So I heard, I don't know if this is true, but like, if like, asking if you want to go eat ramyeon is like the equivalent of like, you know, here in America when you're at a club, you're like, hey, let's get out of here. Or, you know, let's bring the party back to my place. This is the equivalent of that in Korea. It's like, hey, we don't go eat ramyeon 먹고 싶어? Is that true? I need to know.
Nope.
Is this true?
One time.
I'm asking, trying to find out for a friend. Think so. It's different. Ramen is Shin ramyeon is like Korea's national treasure. Their most prized possession. Should I play this at the strip club? Bibimbap is not great. Bibimbap is fucking peasant food. Bulgogi and bibimbap are like the worst fucking shit. I fucking hate both of those so much. Now I'm fucking triggered. Every time I want to go eat Korean barbecue, I go with my fucking friends, and then they're like, okay, we sit down, and they're like, yeah, we'll take 4 orders of bulgogi. I'm like, fuck that shit! No! Sorry. I hate it so much. Bulgogi is like the equivalent of going to a steakhouse and bringing in McDonald's. That's what it is. That's how I feel. Whenever my friends order that bullshit, it's like you might as well have brought McDonald's into the restaurant. You fucking peasant pleb. And the only reason Kalbi is like fucking $28 for one order when it should be like fucking 12, the only reason is that they can mark that shit up and then they can put their shitty bulgogi at like $20 and then be like, oh yeah, so this is the affordable one. Basic kimchi with the 4 months. Thanks for that resub. Oh my god, it's okay, it's cool that the song skips. I don't mind. Anyways, yeah, that shit is fucking terrible. It's so bad, I can't even think of an equivalent of how terrible that is in America. We'll be right back. It is Run the Track, but I like saying Run the Trap. It's kind of like California rolls. Okay, you go to a nice-ass sushi place, and your friend's like, oh my god, I love sushi. You sit down, like, we'll have 4 orders of California rolls, please. Bitch, what the fuck? That was a perfect analogy. Thank you for that. I'm gonna use that from now on. Can someone check the Holy Ship 9.0 lineup? Is Party Favor on it? Because I lose my fucking mind.
Run that back, man.
And no, I'm not even trying to be a snob about food. It's like I am pretty culturally devoid. It's just like I think that bulgogi tastes like shit, and everyone fucking loves it. Wait, James, when I said to make spooky pizza, you straight up went and you made spooky pizza? For real? Yo, can you tweet like a tweet a picture or a video to me or something? I want to see that shit, dude. That's fucking sick. Yo, spooky pizza. Did you use the spooky bloody worms though?
Got the whole cool cat. I think she love me, but I changed the subject and I do my Dougie. All the bros call me lucky cause they see the girl I'm with and she ready, so we rush it. I turned off my kick cause I don't wanna hear no cussing. Cali swag got the haters under their red pussing. Man, you can't tell me nothing. Star made the beat, I just took it out the oven. I just seen the Dougie when everybody clubbing and they yell CSC. Keep it moving. Teach me how to duck, teach me how to duck. Teach me how to duck, teach me how to duck.
Everybody duck, everybody duck. You ain't messing with my duck.
Teach me how to duck. Teach me how to duck. Teach me how to duck. Teach me how to duck.
Everybody duck. Everybody duck. Everybody duck. You ain't messing with my duck.
Thinking out loud. I must have $250,000 on me right now. Hard to make a song about something other than the money. Things I'm about to talk and blunt and staying blunt. And pretty women, are you here? Are you here right now, huh? We should all disappear right now. Look, you're getting all your friends and you're getting in the car and you're coming to the house. I'm clear right now, huh? See the fleet, all the new things. Cop cars with the loose chains. All white like a mood things. Niggas see me rolling and they mood change. Like a motherfucker. New floor, got a dozen of them. I don't trust you, you're undercover. I can probably make some steps, this is what we tell them. Talking for ladies with the trouble butter. Fresh sheets and towels, man, she gotta love it. Yeah, they all get what they desire from it. Well, tell them niggas we ain't hiding from it.
Yo, what up, Hong? The king of chill is here. If you guys are enjoying the chill vibes, check out Pong, fucking awesome DJ right here on Twitch.
Drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot. The pigs try to get at you, park it like it's hot, park it like it's hot, park it like it's hot. If a nigga get an attitude, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Sean Don, and I'm over best me as I got it going on. I'm a nice dude with some nice dreams. See these ice cubes, see these ice creams. Eligible bachelor, $1 million boat. That's whiter than what's spilling down your throat. The phantom, exterior like fish eggs. The interior,
what up, Zark?
I can exercise you, this could be your visit. Cheat on your man, man, that's how you get a his head. Kill it with the beat, I know killers in the street. It's better make you feel like you're chilling in the heat. So don't try to run up on my head, talking all that raspy shit, trying to ask me shit. But my niggas say your best, they ain't gonna pass me shit. You should think about it, take a second. Matter of fact, you should take 4B and think before you fuck a little skateboard. When the pimps in the crib, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot. The pigs try to get it, park it like it's hot, park it like it's hot, park it like it's hot. The nigga get an attitude, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot, pop it like it's hot. I got the rollie on my arm and I'm pouring Sean Don, and I'm over that sweet cause I got it going on. Gangster, what y'all do that? The big boss dog, yeah, I had to do that. I keep a blue flag hanging on my backside, only on the left side, yeah, that's the crib side. Ain't no other way to play the game the way I play. I cut so much you thought I was a DJ.
Oh, 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 oh
Yo, peace out, hi. Have a good one. Oh shit, aioli sounds mad good. Wait, what were you guys saying about CS degrees? Wait, I'll just read chat.
You get what you give, that's the simple truth. So ooh, just lend me a hand and I'll give you some.
Well, I think part of it though, like, a lot of engineers have really shit interview skills. Because, like, you have to learn how to speak confidently about your qualifications. Once you can do that and you are qualified as a with a computer science degree, you can fucking you can do a lot. And a lot of it's not like you're underappreciated. If you think about how much you get paid, like, they're appreciating the fuck out of you. Like, I think I was making like 70 grand a year, something around there. I don't even remember. It was, feels so long ago. But like, I would come into work late as fuck. I'd send like 2 emails. Getting paid that much to do that little, like, yeah. I feel like most people are overpaid. But that's speaking about, like, you know, the actual amount of work that they do. Compared to some, like, the amount of work that they could do. But, you know, if you think about it in global economics and stuff, it makes sense, blah, blah, blah. Like, I was definitely getting overpaid for the amount of work that I personally actually accomplished. But, like, if you look at the economy and what people need, it makes sense to pay someone that helps keep that department running in the company. It makes sense to pay them that much. Could the job have been done better and more efficiently? Yes, absolutely, but that's every job in every department, everywhere. Bring up some new jobbies. I just played like 3 of their songs. No, I was the same way. Like, I started my first coding project. I accidentally did because I was trying to fix a game, and I noticed you could change the settings file, and I just messed around with it to see what would happen. I did that when I was like 9 on my computer, and from there I started getting into coding and shit. And I made some like shitty programs, and like, yeah, but it was really interesting. So when I realized I could do this for a job, and you know, at a much like at an actual professional level, I was like, yeah, hell yeah. Yeah, lots of, yeah, Matt, well, it depends what kind of engineering, but most of the classes, actually almost all engineering classes involve yeah, math and shit. Especially if you're going to computer science, you're gonna have to take a shitload of computer classes. They get pretty complicated, but eh. It's fun, yeah. We'll be right back.
Zombie Apocalypse.
You bet my neighbors hate me, I bet your parents hate you. And actually the music's not that loud, it's like, the music isn't loud. I'm sorry. I'm sure you and your folks get along just fine. I was just being a dick. I used to stream at like this level. Hang on. And like, I started giving myself like fucking hearing damage. So I started turning it down a little. It sucks. It sucks going to bro, I was just kidding. It was a prank, bro. Hey, be nice to the plebs. They're okay too. Plebs are people too. Oh, good joke. What up, Nova? How the fuck is everyone doing tonight? It's fucking Friday. Yo, my sleep schedule is so fucked up right now, guys. I'm sorry. I'm like so out of it. But I'm gonna go as hard as I can for the next however long I'm streaming. We'll be right back.
family. In the mix in the drum. Legacies, family. Ain't see them like a family. Going out like a Montana. Any killers on the hill. Legacies, family. Ain't see them like a family. Pack and smoke, family. Selling ball, family. Game on the match in my Grammy. Can't people ask for Grammy. They make it only the family. Family.
Thank you to last month's Iron DJs for inspiring me to steal those moves. Well, I didn't steal. I did it my way. Holy sh- yo, Chad, you guys are being so fucking dope right now. I agree. Don't give up on that shit. Even if you gotta do something else and put it on the back burner for a while, like, don't lose that fucking fire and shit. Like, when you do get the chance to come back to your dream or your passion or your goals or whatever, like, you know, have that focus at least in the back of your head, so when you come back to it, you can burn the shit out of it.